Hello everyone. Now today we are going to start lecture 2 for the same chapter number 6 division for class 1. In this lecture we are going to discuss about the terms of division. There are some terms included in division like divisor, dividend and quotient. So now we are going to discuss each of these terms one by one. First term is divisor. So divisor means the number from which other number is divided. जिस नंबर से हम लोग दूसरे नंबर को डिवाइड करते हैं दैट इज टर्म्ड एज डिविजर. डिवाइडेंड, डिवाइडेंड मीन्स द नंबर दैट इज बीइंग डिवाइडेड. जो नंबर डिवाइड हो रहा है द नंबर दैट इज बीइंग डिवाइडेड इज नोन एज डिवाइडेंड. एंड क्वेश्चन इज आवर आंसर. द रिजल्ट वी कैन से दैट वी गेट आफ्टर डिविजन दैट इज आवर क्वेश्चन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन 8 डिवाइड बाई 2 इज इक्वल टू 4. Here the number 8 is being divided, so 8 will be termed as dividend. And 2 is the number from which 8 is being divided, so here 2 is termed as divisor. And the result of our division is termed as quotient. So you all are familiar with all these three terms, divisor, dividend and quotient, because sometimes aapko aise questions diye jate hain and you have to write which is divisor, which is dividend or which is quotient. So for that you have to know that what is the meaning of divisor, what is the meaning of dividend and what is the meaning of quotient. Again I am one time telling you that divisor means the number from which other number is divided. Again I am saying divisor means the number from which other number is divided. Dividend is the number that is being divided. Next lectures the long division method, there you will be easier to understand you, but now just you have to remember it. Like 8 is being divided here, so 8 is dividend. 2 is the number from which other number is divided, so 2 is divisor, and our result is the quotient. For example, you can see here, you have to fill in the boxes. Question is, in 30 divided by 6 is equal to 5. What is dividend, what is divisor and what is quotient? So the number that is being divided is 30. So you will write in dividend 30. And 30 is being divided by 6. So 6 is our divisor. We will write 6 in divisor column. And our result of division is the quotient. So our 5 is the quotient. So this is the process of solving questions based on dividend, divisor and quotient. Now children, there are some rules involved in division. You all are familiar with the rules, I already know. But let me explain it once more to you that the division follows certain rules. First rule of division is division by 1. If we divide any number by 1, we get the number itself. That means if we divide 8 by 1, we get the number 8 as itself. This is our first rule of division, that when any number is divided by 1, we get the number itself. Now, rule number 2 says, division of a number by the same number. It means when a number is divided by the number itself, then our result will be 1. You can see here 8 is divided by 8. Both the numbers are same. Or you can say the number is being divided are the common number or the same number we can say. So our result is 1. This is our second rule of division. And the last rule, 0 divided by any number. It means if any number is divided by 0. If any number or if 0 is divided by any number. Sorry, if 0 is divided by any number, then our answer will be 0. Again, I am telling you, like first division by 1, if any number is divided by 1, we get the number itself as 8, you can see here. In rule 2, division of a number by the same number. If the number is being divided by the same number, then our result will be 1. We get the quotient as 1. In rule 3, 0 divided by any number. It means if 0 is divided by any number, if 0 is divided by 8, then also we will get 0. If 0 is divided by 7, again we will get 0. So when 0 is divided by any number, we get the result as 0. Okay, children, now we will move toward division and multiplication fact. Now we are going to discuss about division and multiplication fact. Division and multiplication are inverse operation. Like division is a process of repeated subtraction. It is a process of repeated and multiplication is a process of repeated addition. So we say that multiplication and division are inverse operation. So now you understand why multiplication and division are inverse operation, because division means that it is a process of repeated subtraction and multiplication means that it is a process of repeated addition. So children, for every multiplication fact we get two division fact, and for every division fact we get two multiplication fact. How? So let us solve one example from your book. When you will see your book page number 98, you will see questions are like this. First example is 10 divided by 2 is equal to 5. You have to write two multiplication facts for this. Like this way questions are drawn in your book. So for one division fact there are two multiplication facts. So first multiplication fact will be 2 multiplied by, or you can say here 5 multiplied by 2 is equal to 10, or you can write 2 multiplied by 5 is equal to 10. This is the two multiplication fact for one division fact. Now in next example you can see here 7 multiplied by 6 is equal to 42. This is the multiplication fact and you have to write two division facts for this. So first division fact will be 42 divided by 6 is equal to 7, and second division fact will be 42 divided by 7 is equal to 6. So for one division fact we get two multiplication fact, and for one multiplication fact we get two division fact. So in your book page number 98, all the questions are based on division and multiplication fact. So after solving these examples you will be able to solve your book page number 98. Now we will solve some more examples based on division and multiplication fact. In your book page number 99 you will see question is division using multiplication tables.
क्वेश्चन इज 72 डिवाइड बाय 8 इज इक्वल टू ब्लैंक बॉक्स, 8 डिवाइड बाय 2 इज इक्वल टू ब्लैंक बॉक्स. सो यू हैव टू डू डिवीजन यूजिंग मल्टीप्लीकेशन टेबल. जस्ट नाउ आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट फॉर डिवीजन यूजिंग मल्टीप्लीकेशन टेबल यू हैव टू लर्न द टेबल्स. टेबल इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू टू डिवीजन इन डिवीजन प्रोसेस. Like first question is 72 divided by 8 is equal to how much, and you have to solve this using multiplication table. So you have to recall the table of 8 and you have to see in table of 8 how many times 72 comes. Like if I will write here 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16, 8 threes are 24, 8 fours are 32, 8 fives are 40, 8 sixes are 48, 8 sevens are 56, 8 eights are 64, and 8 nines are 72. So you can see in 8, 9 times 72 comes. So you will write here your answer 9. But this is only possible when you will learn the table of 8. Then only you will able to solve your question using multiplication table. So in the same way, second question you have also write in the same way, 8 divided by 2. So you have to recall table of 2. Like 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6, 2 fours are 8. So you can see in 2, 4 times we get 8. So we will write here 4. So in this way you can solve exercise also based on multiplication table. In our next lecture children, we are going to discuss about long division method of division. Like just now we have read about repeated subtraction, division using multiplication table, division fact, multiplication fact. But in our next lecture, in lecture number 3, we will discuss about long division method. Thank you children.